We're making our way now towards Mundakkai. You can see how treacherous it is. It is courtesy of these army personnel that even this much is possible. Using barricades, wooden planks, they've created this particular bridge here, makeshift obviously. And when the current goes up, this also is completely shut down. Let's make our way towards Mundakkai now. I'm running right through because it's raining as well. Non-stop rain here through the day, and through that the work continuing. Can you believe that where people are right now, this was a temple completely destroyed, because while I've crossed one side of the river and come to this side right now towards Mundakkai as we head there, this entire area, I understand, just about 24 hours ago, actually 36 hours ago, was completely underwater. Now the water levels have come down, which is why you can see efforts to create more and more bridges so that people can come across. Right now, the way I showed you is the only path, because a big bridge that is being constructed by the army, where they've created that column which will be put up, that's yet to be set up. But from here, it's another at least 60-minute walk. I'm going to take you through it to show you exactly what our personnel are going through, the kind of challenges that they're facing terrain-wise, weather-wise, as you can see, and still getting there to rescue every single person. So we'll take you through that particular trek. Let's hope that the weather doesn't stop us. Come with me. This is the entrance. As we just showed you, we walked through that bridge. We're now making our way up there. This is exactly what the area of Mundakkai looked like before the landslide happened. And I've asked this question several times to several authorities about what triggered the landslides. Yes, natural calamity, but also deforestation, tea plantations all across this entire stretch, as far as the eye can see. And it will lead to questions about whether that too was one of the causes for the landslide happening in the manner that it did. Mundakkai was this beautiful. Now, what you'll see when I show you the landslide location will absolutely shock you, because there's nothing left of this beauty. Let's keep going. Another 5 kilometers. As we walk up, I've been speaking to a lot of the people here, and almost all of them are locals who've come up to help. Sorry, ningal evadane
vayanad 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 district sultamathiri
ningal eppo vannu ivade
nane davile 8 o'clock
sanaku evade poi ningal landslide location poyo
avide poi
poite taale
vannu veendum molottu povanu
second time so eppo vannu ningal
naan inne oru 10 mani aagum vannadana innale full time ഇന്നലെ ഫുൾ ടൈം ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ഇന്നലെ രാത്രി മിലിറ്ററി ക്ലോസ് ചെയ്തതിന് ശേഷമാണ് നമ്മൾ പോയത്. ഇവിടുന്ന് അവിടുന്ന് റിക്കവറി ഒരു 25 ബോഡിയോളം നമ്മൾ എന്തുണ്ട് റിക്കവറി ചെയ്ത് കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഇന്നലെ
ഫസ്റ്റ് വരുന്നതാണ്. ഞാൻ ഇന്നലെ പിന്നെ മോർച്ചറിയിലായിരുന്നു ഡ്യൂട്ടി. മോർച്ചറിയിൽ വളരെ
ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടാണ്.
അവിടെ സ്വയം നാട്ടുകാർ കൂടിയിട്ട് അങ്ങ് തെരഞ്ഞെടുക്കലാണ്. ഗ്രൂപ്പാണ് ഇന്ന് ഇന്ന ഡ്യൂട്ടി നമ്മളങ്ങ് മനസ്സറിഞ്ഞ് ചെയ്യാം. ചെയ്തിട്ട് പിന്നെ നമ്മളത് അവിടെ ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്ത് കൊടുക്കുക. ഗവൺമെന്റിന് ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്ത് കൊടുക്കുക.
കേരള മലയാളി സ്റ്റൈൽ സ്റ്റൈൽ ആ ഇത് എവിടെ എന്ത് അപകടം വന്നാലും ഞങ്ങൾ എല്ലാവരും ഒറ്റക്കെട്ടാ. എവിടെ വന്നാലും
ഇത്ര സമയമായിട്ടും അപ്പൊ നമ്മൾ ഇത്രയും ആൾക്ക് നമ്മൾ ഫുഡ് എത്തിച്ചു കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. എന്നിട്ട് നമ്മൾ കഴിച്ചില്ല. അപ്പൊ നമ്മൾ വരുന്ന വഴിക്ക് രണ്ടുപേര് അങ്ങോട്ട് തിരിച്ചു പോവായിരുന്നു. അപ്പൊ അവര് നമുക്ക് വന്ന ഫുഡാണിത്. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് എവിടെയാണോ ഫുഡ് കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ചെയ്യുന്നത്, നമുക്ക് കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ചെയ്ത് നിക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല. നമുക്ക് എവിടുന്നാണോ കിട്ടുന്നത് നമുക്ക് അവിടുന്ന് കഴിക്കാന്നുള്ള
ഒരു കുടുംബമാണ്.
ഒരു കുടുംബം പോലെ ചോദിച്ചിട്ട് ഇവന് ഫുഡ് കഴിച്ചിട്ടില്ല, അവനക്ക് കൊടുക്കും.
നിങ്ങളുടെ സർവീസ്ക്ക് താങ്ക് യു. സോ ഓൾ ഓഫ് ദം വാക്കിംഗ് അപ്പ് ഹിൽ സേയിങ് സെവറൽ ടൈംസ് ദേവ് ഡൺ ഇറ്റ് and continue to do so. They're not part of any organization, any of that. They're locals who heard of the news and decided, look, amid this torrential rain, we're going to come here, do everything we can to help. And that's the spirit of Kerala that you see here, that I'm witnessing. Behind me is the entire stretch of the river there flowing through. And you can see the rocks that is brought along as a result of the landslide. 2 days back, when the landslide happened, the water was right up till here. Now it's receded and left behind all of that debris. Locals tell me that it was along this stretch the bodies were washed up. A lot of the bodies were found almost 20-30 kilometers away from where I'm standing, which is where the actual landslide took place. So you can imagine the amount of debris that really pushed all of these homes, bodies, families across till the very end. Even now at this point, rescue operations continue. You can see there are several officials out there, but it's impossible really to sift through, dig through all of that debris. That big mound behind me, it's untouched so far. And God alone knows what's left there, the remnants of families, of homes, which they suspect could be in that debris. But they can get to that only once they finish at the landslide zone, which we're going to next. As we speak, bodies are being pulled out, so the rescue operation is still very much continuing in many pockets where officials are reaching and realizing only now that the landslide has hit here too, that houses have been completely destroyed in many of these circumstances, and just the sheer nature of this tragedy can be summed up in the images I'm showing you. Many of these circumstances, locals tell me that they're not able to find more than body parts, but they're still treating it with the respect and dignity that it deserves. So many people who've gathered here, you see the kind of resource it takes really for this kind of an operation, every single one of them involved because of the terrain. And once the body, the mortal remains are taken down from that particular spot where it was discovered. And, you know, officials have been here for the last half an hour. They've been digging with their hands, essentially, to reach the mortal remains, to reach that body. Because as soon as they caught a glimpse, they had to then use their hands because of how loose the soil is. As you can see, gingerly, the body parts being brought down, the body being brought down right now by officials who have been working day in and day out, risking their own lives in this inclement weather to do everything they can to ensure every person who is struck in this landslide is treated with dignity. I apologize for bringing you these kind of sensitive images, but this is the nature of tragedy that we're actually dealing with, where every 15 minutes another body is pulled out by the officials who are working here through the heavy rain from early morning till late into the night, till sundown. And from here, it's at least 1 hour that you'll have officials actually walking right down to the spot where the ambulance can reach them, because the ambulance can't come up to where we've come. They have to trek all the way, sir, India Today. They have to trek all the way to the other side. And that's where the ambulance can actually take the mortal remains to a morgue. And in some cases, injured people also being pulled out, which is nothing short of a miracle. Still bodies are there, sir.
Still bodies are there. And here, overall, we don't know how much houses are there, but we can see 10 to 15 houses in this side. So, we are searching, and we got right now 4 bodies. The people saying from here, people telling that there is some more bodies. Before that, the people all went to, So, now...
How much longer do you think the rescue operation here will...
Yesterday this happened yesterday morning, 1:30 a.m. So on that time onwards, rescue non-stop. People don't have food, and people doing well work, and we are very salute for the Kerala people and Kerala rescue people. I did not see like this kind of rescue in anywhere, but Kerala people very, very, very incredible. We cannot say how the people were doing. So according to my experience, it's very, we can't to say the words put across.
Thank you for everything you're doing also for this. You can see the water flowing by. In this particular area, there's water flowing through the entire location. People are walking by and helping in every way they can. But you heard the gentleman there who's been a part of the rescue operations. What they're doing here is nothing short of heroic. So many locals, officials are risking their lives to come here in this pouring rain. You've been seeing how it's non-stop raining. This entire stretch here, there's absolutely nothing left. And this was an area full of tea plantations, full of homes, nearly 400 families washed away as a result of these landslides. And you can see the path that the landslide took, all the boulders, remnants of the landslide. You can see in this area, you see one or two houses left behind, but otherwise all other houses completely washed away. And just imagine what these people were going through. 1 a.m., fast asleep, the roof suddenly collapses over them. They have no idea what's happening. Wake up, some of them miraculously alive, live to tell the tale. Others, unfortunately, meeting the fate that we just showed you. Heartbreaking, really, to report on this kind of a tragedy for us. But this is the scale of rescue operation that's underway. 2 days on, this is the second day of rescue operations, and looks like, based on what officials tell us, it could take a couple days more, especially because of the challenges they're facing with the terrain and the weather. This is where all of the rescue operations continue, even as remnants of the house are being pulled apart right now to reach the bodies that still remain in this debris. With video journalist Sachin Chandok, this is Akshita Nandagopal reporting for India Today from Wayanad.